In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to our celebration on New Year's Day, as well as the Solemnity of Mary, the Holy Mother of God. In our readings today, we hear about blessings and mercy. So for the times that we haven't always been open to God's blessings or mercy, we pause and ask and take the time to ask today for that as we begin the new year. Lord Jesus, you are Son of God and Son of Mary. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you plead for us at the right hand of the Father. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you show us the way to the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Numbers. The Lord said to Moses, "Speak to Aaron and his sons and tell them, 'This is how you shall bless the Israelites. Say to them, the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord let his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you kindly and give you peace.' So shall they invoke my name upon the Israelites, and I will bless them." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Galatians. Brothers and sisters, when the fullness of time had come, God sent his Son, born of a woman, born under the law, to ransom those under the law, our sons, God sent the Spirit of His Son into our hearts, crying out, Abba, Father. So you are no longer a slave, but a son. And if a son, then also an heir through God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. If I were one to make New Year's resolutions, one would be try to be on time. Well, we see how that one started off the New Year's. Actually, I was on time, but we had a little Wi-Fi issue going on, which was resolved, and then I realized I had three add-ons, actually, to the prayers of the faithful, but that's just an excuse, right? So there was no 9 o'clock Mass this morning, so I can't even say, oh, I ran late at St. John's, so... My apologies for starting a couple of minutes late. But the other thing was, yesterday we had the vigil at St. John's, and we didn't have the song sheet. So today was the first time I ever heard that first song, and it reminds me when I lived in California, in December time frame, and even in January, people would be walking around going, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. And I always used to say to them, obviously you never lived back east. Because that's not a favorite song unless you live right near the ski lodges. But so that reminded me, the snow lay on the ground. I've never heard that one before, but obviously that's the first few words of the song. But as we were singing it, I noticed, did you see at the bottom, it's from Albany, New York or something. So I'm not sure who that was, in 18-something or other, so 1860. So in any event, the key word today, throughout the readings and throughout this holy day, dedicated to Mary, the Mother of God, is the word blessings. And we can look back on 2020 and think, were we really blessed? We had the virus, we had the, you know, all the shutdown and all this stuff or whatever. But I think if we actually did sit down and take a few moments, I think we would each find that we had blessings throughout the year. Many of us have never had the COVID, so that's a good blessing, that's a blessing. And perhaps if we had, maybe we've recovered, or it could be worse, as they say. So we count our blessings. And as we look forward into 2021, we look for additional blessings. And we ask for the intercession of Mary, the mother of Jesus, and therefore the mother of God, whose feast we obviously celebrate today on January 1st. And in the readings, that first reading from the book of Numbers talks about the blessing of the Israelites. And that was a blessing that was used thousands of years ago. But it's continued. It's never been meant for, okay, one and done. Here's your blessing, get on the road. Kind of like some of our sacraments, like baptism or something. But that means that it's also that blessing from the book of Numbers is a blessing for each one of us. And I'm sure some of you have heard that before, whether in the reading or at the end of Mass. It's one of the optional solemn blessings, they call them. And I'll use that at the end of Mass today. And it's used for many different occasions. It is used again and again to evoke the generosity of God's care on those who ask for and are open to God's grace and blessings. And then in that psalm, Psalm 67, that we just sang the response, may God bless us in his mercy. We are all in need of God's blessing and God's mercy. Every Mass we start out with some sort of penitential rite. Many times it's Lord have mercy, Christ have mercy, Lord have mercy. And that's part of the introductory parts of the Mass so that we can enter into the holy sacrifice of the Mass appropriately and in God's grace and mercy. So, of course, the question today is, are each of us, are we open to God's mercy, to God's grace, to God's blessing on this, the first day of the new year, and throughout our lives? And then Paul, in the letter to the Galatians, he speaks of each of us being children of God. We are called children of God by virtue of our baptism, and we are blessed in that. Because of Jesus Christ, who said to his disciples before he left, go baptize in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Jesus, the Son of God and the Son of Man. So we are children of God. And then in Luke, the Christmas reading continues. The shepherds were amazed, and all the people were amazed at what the shepherds were telling them. And Mary, of course, kept all these things reflecting on them in her heart. We are blessed because of God, because of Mary's yes to God, which brought forth the Son of God and the Son of Man, who blesses us if we are open to it and we ask for it. So I invite you today, each of us, to meditate, to pray, to pause, and think about the gentle, humble, contemplative spirit of Mary as a means of being blessed by God. Blessings for her, for Joseph, for the people of Israel, and for the countless people since. Blessings for each one of us in 2021. All those blessings we've received in 2020. May God bless all people with goodwill now and always.
Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell, and on the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Through the Holy Spirit, Mary became the Virgin Mother of Jesus Christ. With the Blessed Mother, we offer our intercessions.
That the leaders of the world combine effort to work for world peace, we pray to the Lord.
Amen. praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
God, who give us the gift of true prayer and of peace, graciously grant that, through this offering, we may do fitting homage to your divine majesty, and by partaking of this sacred mystery, we may be faithfully united in mind and heart through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift up the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord, our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, and to praise, bless, and glorify your name on this, the solemnity of the motherhood of the Blessed Ever-Virgin Mary. For by the overshadowing of the Holy Spirit, she conceived your only begotten Son, and without losing the glory of virginity, brought forth into the world the eternal light, Jesus Christ, our Lord. For through him the angels praise your majesty, dominions adore, and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exaltation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we acclaim. Jesus took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, Jesus took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We offer you, Heavenly Father, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy
to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Jesus Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Edward, our Bishop, Howard, our Bishop Emeritus, and all the clergy, religious, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Remember your servants whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he and they are who were united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, glorious martyrs, St. John the Baptist, St. Catherine of Siena, and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. We dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Say the words and my soul.
Let us say our spiritual communion prayer together. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament of the altar. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. We have received this heavenly sacrament with joy, O Lord. Grant, we pray, that it may lead us to eternal life. For we rejoice to proclaim the blessed ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of your Son and Mother of the Church, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you, everyone, for joining us, whether here in church or online. I wish you all the happiness and health during the full 2021. If you're looking for a calendar, we still have some, and we have some of those books as well. And if you're watching and you'd like either one of those, give the parish office a call, and we'll figure out a way to get it to you. So hope you enjoy the rest of the holiday and have a safe trip wherever you may be traveling. Please bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. May the Lord bless you and keep you forever. Amen. May he let his face shine upon you and show you his mercy. Amen. May he turn his countenance toward you and give you his peace forever. Amen. And may the blessing of God, the Almighty Father, Son, and Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you forever and ever.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Sacred Heart of Jesus,
have mercy on us.
Our Lady of God,
intercede for us.
Saint John the Baptist,
pray for us.
God bless everyone.